Hey, what's up everyone, I am Nitij and in this video, I will try to explain the Liskov substitution principle as easily as possible, which is one of the solid principles when it comes to software engineering practices. The Liskov substitution principle is one of those topics in which programmers get confused, especially when it comes to programming interviews. It is also one of the most commonly asked questions in interviews for object-oriented programming and solid principles. The important thing about the LSP is to identify if any subclass is correctly sticking to its core principle or not, but more on that later. Let's just start with the core definition of LSP, and then I will try to explain as clearly as possible the Liskov substitution principle, and hopefully you will be able to understand it if you don't already know about it. The Liskov substitution principle was introduced by Barbara Liskov in a 1987 conference called Data Abstraction and Hierarchy. This principle was later defined in a 1994 paper by Barbara Liskov and Janet Wing. So this is how LSP is defined. Let phi x be a property provable about objects x of type t, then phi y should be true for objects y of type s, where s is a subtype of t. So if this is hard for you to understand, then don't worry, I will translate it for you. What this definition means is if there is a subtype S of type T, then objects of type T which are being used in a program can be replaced with objects of subtype S without changing the state of a program from correct to incorrect. Still not clear about it? Well, don't worry. I have some more explanation and a couple of code examples lined up for you, so do watch this video till the end. By definition, it looks like whenever we have a subclass which can replace a parent class, we are fulfilling the LSP, but this is not as simple as that. In any object-oriented language, any subclass instantiation can be used in place of its parent class. If it overrides all the properties and methods of a superclass, then it can completely replace its usage in a program. But here's the thing. A subclass will break LSP if its behavior does not always match with the behavior specified by the contract of the parent class. The simplest way to check this is if the subtype replacing supertype actually makes sense to do so in all situations. Over here in this code snippet, there are two classes. First one is class food, which is a supertype or a parent type, and then there is class pizza, which is inheriting from class food. Now over here, the pizza class is overriding the virtual methods of food class, but the pizza class is doing some more stuff within the gather ingredients function, which is to be expected for this class to be different from the food class. Now consider this. We can create an object out of the food class and then we can call its functions one by one by providing all the required arguments. And we can also replace this instantiation of food type with a type of pizza, and the program will still run as it is intended because pizza is also type of a food, right? So what we can do is food equals to new pizza, and the program is still correct. The behavior of pizza class is still matching with the food class. So over here we can say that the Liskov substitution principle is being followed when we are replacing the supertype food with subtype pizza. So here is another example. I have replaced food with healthy food, which means that this class is only for those foods which are healthy. Now this time class pizza is inheriting from healthy food class. Would it be correct to say that pizza is healthy food? I don't think so. With lots of cheese and lots of ketchup, we cannot call pizza as healthy food. Although some of you can argue that we can cook a pizza in a healthy way, but let's be honest with each other. With lots of cheese and lots of ketchup, pizza cannot be called as healthy food. So does that mean the Liskov substitution principle can be followed over here? I don't think so, because even though the pizza class is successfully overriding the virtual methods of healthy food, the behavior of this pizza class is not matching with the intended behavior of this healthy food class. So places where healthy food is expected, we cannot replace those instances of healthy food with pizza class, because that would really give another meaning to the usage of the healthy food object instances. Let me give you another very simple example, which you might have already seen in many places if you have already read about Liskov substitution principle, because this is the most common example that everyone throws around. Can a square inherit from a rectangle class? Certainly so. But can the square class implementation replace the rectangle implementation everywhere in a program? I don't think so, because in only one case, the square can be a rectangle when the width and height are same. But in all the other cases, a square can never be a rectangle. So even though mathematically a square is a rectangle, but when used in a program, this will not really make much sense, because we cannot always replace a rectangle object with a square object every single time in a program. So this implementation over here is not following the Liskov substitution principle. A subclass may fulfill the attribute requirements of the parent class in the sense that it can override the parent class methods with the same sets of arguments and may produce same sets of results. But if it is violating the behavioral requirements of the contract of the superclass, then it is not LSP. Like over here, even though this pizza subclass is successfully overriding the virtual methods in a seemingly correct way, the behavior of this pizza class is going to be different from the healthy food class. I know that the code examples that I have demonstrated are very simple in nature, but it's the easiest way to understand Liskov substitution principle. Within a project, a developer would need a good understanding of the scope under which the superclass and subclass are being used to identify if the LSP is correctly being followed or not. The compiler of a programming language cannot really identify the LSP substitutability. Human interventions are required by means of code reviews to check if the LSP requirements are being fulfilled or not by a subclass. So, does it make sense to be concerned about substitutability in terms of LSP? For the most part, yes. Subclasses following Liskov substitution principle makes it less confusing for developers when they will have to extend base classes in order to replace its use with a child class. The code will be safer, robust, and will require fewer tests to check if it will fail under production settings. So that was everything in this video to learn about LSP. Have any questions? Feel free to use the comments area. If you like this video, then please place a like on it. Also, don't forget to subscribe to this channel if you haven't done that already to get to know about the latest videos. I'm Nitij, and I will see you next time. Till then, stay safe and have fun.